doing. I think those that know me know that my focus is primarily women, and so I like to continue to raise the voices of women in this movement and who are impacted by the injustice system and incarceration and all the systems that are in place that are carceral. I created an initiative now under From Life to Life. It's called Women Transcending. I say it's an initiative, give me 3 months, I'm gonna call it a movement. Because what I'm doing is bringing women, primarily in New York, but I'm gonna allow it to be nationwide, women who have been directly impacted, as I said, but who have suffered violence throughout their lives or at some point in their lives, who have then went on to be incarcerated because of that violence that's been in their lives. Because oftentimes we hear the stories of women, but we don't understand what happened to lead a woman or a young girl to prison or jail. And what we do know is that over 95% of women and girls that are in prisons or jails have been subjected to some form of abuse in their lives, and they are in the situation they're in because of that violence. It's not that they actually committed a violent act, it's because they were part of it in some way, usually under duress and coercion, like myself. And so I realize that that is the norm and that's the truth. And so I like to elevate those voices of women, because women are not in this movement loudly, and we are not portrayed in the way that we should be portrayed. And I refuse to have women silenced and marginalized anymore. I have left people after 27 years who are still in there from the 1970s, and they should not be there. They should have been out here before I was. And I refuse to not have their voices and their stories brought out. And so I'm feeling that women are a strong part of this movement, and it's gonna be the reason why this movement succeeds, because we have to be equally balanced in the conversation, in the movement, and seen as human and as equal.